What's up, guys? It's Legomation Studio here with another LEGO Lord of the Rings review. This time we'll be reviewing Shelob Attacks, or Shelob's Lair, the giant spider. Basically, you know what happens in this scene. Frodo is captured, and so Samwise Gamgee comes in to save the day. And then Gollum is in here as well, which I think is a nice little addition. They really made this set a good little set. You get the awesome spider to it, and everybody wants a giant LEGO spider. It's 227 pieces, and I believe had a price range of, yes, $20. So, great price for 227 pieces. You divide that by 10, it should be $22 or even $23. It's $20. Great deal, great deal, great deal. On the back, we have, as advertised, the weapons displayed and the One Ring to rule them all. The spider capturing Frodo, pretty much is the same picture from the front. Just some more pictures with Frodo and Sam confronting Gollum. Gollum with a fish. Gollum jumping out to scare Frodo. And then the actual spider with the thread that comes out of its butt. Like a little line, like a real spider would leave. A web function displayed. So very cool, very cool. And then Frodo, poor Frodo, about to get attacked. Poor little guy. And then the video game and its rating. I really like the way they do these boxes, by the way. It's literally a map of Middle Earth. I think that's so cool. So cool. Alright, let's open it up and take a look at the figures. Alright guys, it's the minifigures. Let's check out Frodo. So Frodo is now in his Return of the King attire. He has his full-on vest, and he's holding a ring. He has his cape, but he has the scared face because he is being attacked and paralyzed by Shelob and her web. We have a normal face as well. Another little interesting thing about this is that the capes are extra small, so they fit the hobbits. Very cute. Then we have Samwise Gamgee. He has his red hair, his classic red hair. He's holding the thing Galadriel gave Frodo in the beginning to scare off spiders, I guess. It's a giant light. Never really understood its purpose. It makes more sense if you read the books, though. He's holding a sword. I think it's meant to be Sting, actually. And then I like his little outfit, his little hobbit outfit. Detail on the back as well. Same with Frodo. Feel like it's unnecessary to go over, but I'd do it anyways. And yeah, just a really good little Samwise Gamgee figure. And then we check out Gollum. Gollum is the losing an arm. That's what Gollum is doing. No, Gollum is the average Gollum that they've been releasing. I really like that they made him in this. I was for the longest time questioning how they were going to make a Gollum. I think it'd be cool if his back legs moved, but they don't. It's just his front arms. But you get that he's hunching over and he's little Gollum, very scary looking. I like how they did his blue eyes, just everything. Very nice detail on this figure. And then he can hold a fish and eat it. I like my fish raw and wriggling. Alright, now let's take a look at the rest of this set. Quickly, we'll just take a look at the little stone place. You can hide Gollum in this little thing compartment here, just like so. And then you press this, and he comes out, and he pops, and can scare Frodo or whoever, Samwise Gamgee, who's standing in front of this little lair. They added this just because they needed some more pieces. I feel like some more cliff sides or rock sides would have made more sense, because why are you... You might as well not even include this. But they are, because you need somewhere for Gollum to hide in and be watching the things that are unfolding in front of him. So, yeah, it's a nice little lair that they give him. Then, we'll just keep recording and take a look at Shelob herself. Uh-oh, her string is coming out of her butt. How do you wind it? Like this. Yes. So as you can see, I'm showing you the function that you can take the string and use it as her actual web that she releases, and you can just wind it right back up inside her. It's really awesome. It's an awesome, awesome function because it makes it more like a spider so kids can play and reenact Frodo getting caught up in a web. So here it is, Shelob in all of her scary spider glory. As far as building experience goes, it was very fun to build, very Technic-esque. A lot of these bendy pieces with brown and black throughout. You can see they include all of her eyes on her face. Let me move it closer. And it's not sticker too, which is great because I hate stickers. These are actual pieces with the eyes on it. So it looks awesome. One of her eyes is even squinting because it's got stabbed before. So just tremendous detail. The two fangs, some more pieces up here just add to the detail. Look underneath, you can kind of just see the way it works. Has wheels here in case the arms, that's yours, Dahlia, go up too much. You can just roll it on a surface. Very awesome. And this is the gear you use to twist in order to make the web go in and out. Mobility-wise, very mobile. You can move the back entirely like so. And the front. And then the legs all move. They have one, two, three points of articulation going vertically and then one going horizontally. So a lot of very good opportunities for Lego stop motion with this figure. So you have a lot of opportunities for doing something like that, and playability is fantastic. So the spider, they did a great job. I feel like the legs are a little skinny, but if you watch the movie, it's like the legs are really skinny, so it's just like it is in the movie. Alright, now let's take a look at this set all together. Alright, so here's the entire set together. We have Shelob, we have Frodo and Sam, Gollum, and his little cave. Okay, I'll go back to my hands. So, here's Frodo all wrapped up. Here, you can zoom into this. Frodo! You're all tied up inside of a spider web. Alright, focus again. So, as you can see, the mobility of this set is fantastic. They had a lot of cool creativity going into this set, and it looks just like the scene does. Some more rocks would have been nice if they were going to go this route, but if not, they should have just not included this and maybe worked more on Shelob. But it is really cool. If I were to rate this set, I'd give it 8 out of 10, 4 out of 5. It's perfect, not up my alley specifically, but if you really like this scene and you like Shelob, perfect. Great to add to your collection because it's a very, very, very famous scene from Lord of the Rings, and I think LEGO did a very great job of portraying it in this set. Anyways, if you want to go out and buy this, the price tag was $20. Hopefully they have it somewhere on Amazon or eBay or in the stores besides LEGO. I don't know. Maybe post in the comment section. Have you seen this in the LEGO store? Do they still sell it on the website? I don't know for sure. But these were awesome sets, and I'll continue reviewing them. We'll see you guys later, and this is LEGOmation Studio, signing out.